Baylor baseball picked up a rising junior and a former freshman All-American at center field from Gonzaga. The name is Enzo, E-N-Z-O, Apodaca, A-P-O-D-A-C-A. He's a fifth commit in the front of transfer portal for Mitch Thompson and staff. And I'm going to go over his stats this past year. He's 5'9", 180 pounds. I know he's not a huge dude, but when you look at the numbers, he could very well make an impact right away. Like, this past year, he's 281 in batting average. He started all 52 games a year ago. He had 13 doubles, 3 triples, 3 home runs, 23 RBIs, 56 hits overall, 39 of those. He got, once he touched the base, he scored. Slugging percentage of 422. He had 23 walks, 10 hit by a pitch, 33 strikeouts. It could be better on that category, but it was better than his first year, I tell you that much. And his on-base percentage is like .382. His fielding percentage, out of like 124 putouts, he had 3 assists, and 2 of those were only errors, .84, which could be a little bit better. You want to be close to 1.0 as possible. But this is still a good pickup, but as a freshman, he hit .279, started 55 games out of 56, had 240 at-bats. He had 67 hits, 19 of those are doubles, 2 of those triples, 3 home runs, 45 RBIs, slugging percentage of .413, 21 walks, 46 strikeouts though, 10 by hit by a pitch, but the strikeouts cut down significantly. So, really, this helps a lot for Baylor baseball. Granted, he does need to make the roster in the spring because you know it's going to be cut down to 40 players in all this. And he also was an all-star in the Cape Cod League this past summer with a .313 batting average and .413 on base percentage across 64 at-bats for the Yarmouth Dennis Red Sox as of July 18th. Of course, Baylor baseball still needs to address the pitching because that was one of the weaknesses for the team last year when you look at the ERA. In order to win games, you got to have pitching. Well, that's one of the easiest ways besides having the offense and the defense to help yourself, but there's no question that Enzo is going to be a starter, assuming that he should make the roster. And he's probably could very well be potentially like a top of the batting lineup. And this does move like MCC transfer Ty Johnson, who was slated to be center field next season, to move to second base, so really that helps to give more versatility. And I know some people were not happy about the Ryan Martinez shortstop addition from San Francisco. If nothing else, he's not going to make the roster. Granted, Mason Greer should make the roster. Patrick Hale should make the roster from Lamar and Jack Little as well. They do have like 23 returnees right now. And 13 of those are freshmen, 6 incoming JUCOs. So, they might also look at another position player besides a pitcher. And we know school's coming around a corner here. So, they got to work fast on this. And I trust Mitch Thompson and staff. And I know next year is going to be 13 teams in baseball. And how the Big 12 term is going to work, I don't have a clue. But we have to wait and see on that, and hopefully they could do better than this past year and not miss the Big 12 tournament again. But I know this is more like than just a one-year process in all this, because look, it takes a couple of years, like 3 to you can't really judge Mitch Thompson on his recruits until year 3. because some of the guys were still dealing with Coach Rodriguez guys. You give him like 3 to 6 years, and yeah, we'll be year 3 to 6. Give him up to 6 years just to give him some time, especially with the ever-changing landscape in college athletics. As we all know, Arizona is coming in 2025. I mean, a year from now, in the baseball season, of course, is spring 2025. Arizona State as well. In addition, Utah. So, and Colorado does not have baseball. So, that for what it's worth, and we know Ohio State does not have baseball either. They got rid of the baseball program a while back now. So, anyways, if you like this content, like and subscribe, and see you guys learn, find scars around the road to it. Let's go.